Hello, and welcome to RSNA Case of the Week. My name is Syed Wakasamad, and I'm a radiology resident at Cooper University Hospital in Camden, New Jersey. Today's case is going to be colovesical fistula. Our case involves a patient with a complicated medical and surgical history. This is a 63-year-old male with history of small bowel adenocarcinoma, cecal adenocarcinoma, and rectal adenocarcinoma with liver metastases who received FOLFOX chemotherapy, low anterior resection of his rectal adenocarcinoma, partial small bowel resection, ileocolectomy with ileocolic anastomosis, and diverting loop colostomy, who initially presented with abdominal pain and malaise. A contrast-enhanced CT scan was initially obtained in the emergency department. Coronal reformatted images demonstrate the large bowel being diverted up the left side of the abdomen and terminating in a left lower quadrant colostomy, as demonstrated by the yellow and blue arrows in figure A. In figure B, we can see that there's posterior bladder wall thickening demonstrated by the white arrow adjacent to the rectosigmoid colon. Sagittal reformatted images redemonstrate posterior bladder wall thickening adjacent to the rectosigmoid colon. Incidentally noted is a rectus sheath mass, which is due to known metastatic disease, as shown in the blue arrowhead. A right renal calculus was noted on the CT scan, for which a nuclear medicine renal scan was obtained. Dynamic images were obtained after the administration of technetium Mag-3 and 30 mg of furosemide. These images demonstrate excretion of radiotracer from the left kidney into the collecting system, into the ureter and bladder, with apparent fistulization with the rectum and subsequent reflux up into the colon, which terminates in the colostomy bag. Also, the right kidney shows markedly diminished perfusion, extraction, and clearance. Here are a few static images from that dynamic scan. On the image to the left, there is excretion of radiotracer from the left kidney into the collecting system, ureter, and bladder at 11 minutes post-administration, as demonstrated by the white arrow. In the middle image, radiotracer activity extends into the bowel at 28 minutes post-administration, as demonstrated by the yellow arrow, and up into the colostomy bag at 45 minutes post-administration, as demonstrated by the blue arrow on the right image. Thus, the final diagnosis of colovesical fistula was made. This is a common post-surgical and neoplastic complication involving the colon. On CT, we saw an area of inflammation adjacent to the bladder wall with the colon, which was suggestive of colovesical fistula. In this case, radiotracer can be seen refluxing up from the bladder into an ectopic site adjacent to the left kidney, which is the location of the patient's colostomy bag. There are a few differential diagnoses to consider in this case. For instance, there's urinoma, for which ectopic radiotracer would be seen collecting in the region of the abdominal cavity and would not be expected to reach the colostomy bag. Similarly, in vesical ureteral reflux, it can be seen on renal scans, however, the radiotracer would not be seen reaching the colostomy bag as it was in this case. The take-home message for this case is that colovesical fistula represents an abnormal connection between the urinary bladder and the bowel. Diverticulitis and Crohn's colitis remain the most common inflammatory etiologies related to the formation of colovesical fistula, with colonic adenocarcinoma being the most common neoplastic etiology. Clinically, the combination of pneumaturia and or fecal urea is shown to have sensitivity as high as 88% in the diagnosis of colovesical fistula. Regarding the imaging features in colovesical fistula, CT has shown to have sensitivity greater than 90% in detection. Findings on CT scans that should raise suspicion for colovesical fistula include the presence of oral or rectal contrast material in the bladder, air in the bladder with absent iatrogenic cause, and presence of inflammation between adjacent bowel and bladder. Regarding prognosis and treatment, sepsis remains the primary clinical concern regarding colovesical fistula, and this is due to translocation of bacteria from the gastrointestinal tract into the bladder and ascending up the urinary tract, causing recurring bouts of cystitis and pyelonephritis. Surgical repair is currently the gold standard of treatment for colovesical fistula. And that's it for this case. I hope you enjoyed.